What is going on, football fans? Back at it with another New York Giants video as news has started to break. Now, we know with the salary cap being reduced that there is probably going to be restructures, not just on the Giants, but several teams. And one player I thought for sure that, you know, possible is Kevin Zeitler, Nate Solder, maybe an extension to Martinez, potentially even Bradbury. But one guy I thought for sure would absolutely be cut due to the fact that he wasn't even used that much and the fact that he's overpaid. And he's a luxury that right now the New York Giants, at least in my opinion, cannot afford, is Levine Toilolo. Toilolo last year was the third string tight end for the New York Giants. He was brought over from the San Francisco 49ers. And I forgot the length of the contract, but he's due to make almost $3 million this year. And we're going to pull up the exact quote. And he carries no dead cap hit. So that $3 million in savings could go a long way towards potentially trying to bring back players like Leonard Williams or Dalvin Tomlinson. Apparently, according to Ian Rappaport, the Giants will be bringing back Levine Toilolo next season. Now, I cannot flip out in this video because, like I said, I don't know the contract details yet. The good news is he will be restructured. The Giants are bringing back veteran tight end Levine Toilolo for 2021, source said, on a restructured contract. He was set to make $2.95 million in 2021. The reason you can't flip out if you're a Giants fan and you're being rational, if you don't know the contract details, is there's going to be back end of the roster guys that make $800,000, $1 million. And if they restructure to that kind of salary, I'm okay with it. I mean, I'm fine with it as long as he's making a near a minimum salary. In my opinion, can we afford to pay Levine Toilolo with the condensed budget even $2.25 or $2.5 million? Absolutely not. If it's $1.5 million, will I flip out? No, but I would prefer it to be a league minimum salary. Otherwise, I would have rather just kept the $3 million in savings. Toilolo last year was barely on the field. I think he took 27. It depends on where you read. I've read upwards of 34% of the snaps. Regardless, he wasn't out there that much. Obviously, he doesn't contribute as a pass catcher. Caden Smith is above him in that department, along with, obviously, Evan Ingram. He's a third-string tight end that's brought in here on goal line packages to block. And he's a decent blocker. That was the book on him when we brought him in here. And you need players like that. But are players like that worth even $2 or $2.5 million when the salary cap is going down? No. We could absolutely use that money. So it's impossible for me to answer right now if I'm pissed off about this move because I don't know what they're restructuring it to. If it's $1 million, there's nothing to be upset about. You're going to have to pay some of these guys, undrafted free agents, $1 million, which at this point in time, that's probably what Levine Toilolo is. You know, a lot of people thought last year when the Giants signed him that they overpaid. So let's wait as Giants fans before we flip out and go crazy. Let's wait to see the contract details. If it's a lot of money, well, not a lot of money. It's not going to be a lot of money no matter what. It's being restructured down from $3 million. But if it's $2 or $2.5 million, yeah, I'll be the first to say I think it was the wrong move. Now, what could this potentially indicate for the New York Giants at the tight end position? Because how many tight ends could you carry on a roster, right? He is the third string tight end. As of now, we still have Evan Ingram. And, of course, we still have Caden Smith. Now, we all assumed that we would be down to two and Toilolo would be off the team. That is not the case. And I would only imagine that Caden Smith will not be off the team. He only makes $850,000 and is a valuable contributor in the H-back role. So, if all three remain on the team, does that potentially mean that the New York Giants may or may not be interested in drafting Kyle Pitts? Because how many tight ends are you going to roster? You could ask yourself that. Obviously, he's not a pass catcher. He doesn't fill that vacancy. But you'd already have three tight ends rostered on this team. Of course, a lot of people feel that Kyle Pitts is just as much a wide receiver as anything else. So maybe it doesn't have any effect whatsoever. Obviously, I know Kyle Pitts is a fan favorite right now. The other thing you could say is, could it potentially be setting up an Evan Ingram trade? To which I'll say, I don't know if this really has much of an effect in that area either, because there's no guarantee that Kyle Pitts will even be there at number 11 to replace Evan Ingram. If the right deal presents itself, you always listen. I don't think this is going to have much of an effect in that area, but it could. Maybe the Giants are telling you, we're happy with the tight ends we got, and we're going to go out there, we're going to try to get a wide receiver or defense. We're going to have to wait and see how the whole free agency period plays out. But am I surprised by this move? Yeah. And unless it's damn near close to a league minimum salary, I will be against this decision by Dave Gettleman and the New York Giants. And I'm a guy that usually tries to understand the things that the New York Giants are doing. Like I said, if it's $1 million, whatever, it's a good move, fine. But if it's anything more than that, in the $2 to $2.5 million range, yeah, as Giants fans, I think you have a right to be upset with the condensed market and everything else when you're trying to get as much potential money as you can get. I think Toilolo is a contributor, but not really a luxury we can afford at the price that he was going into the season. Thankfully, he will not be making that. The question is, how much will he make? If it's a league minimum salary, I'm okay with it. As always, guys, if you liked what you watched, please subscribe. Drop a comment. Maybe give me a little thumbs up. Cheers.